Okay, hi, ladies and gentlemen. I just want to say a few words by way of a quick welcome. And the welcome also includes a small apology. Let me begin with the apology first. This is reversing the trend a little bit. We were hard put to get a week for this festival, which would suit at least a majority of our writers, as well as not clash with the F1. And after a lot of toing and froing, we finally chose this particular week. However, this week, as all Singaporeans know, is school holiday week. And this is why there are a lot of empty seats, which has not been the case in the previous years, because it was school term and we have a lot of people from the schools coming in and filling up the seats as well. So this is a little bit unusual, and I want to apologize to the writers and family that this is not the usual scheme of things. But the flip side is that I hope most of you will have all of you except yet coming a bit later. All four of you will have more time on your hands. Otherwise, your Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, very busy, you know, visiting school, you know, running around, and the minders are great fun running around and all that. But this time will not. So on that note, I'll say a very happy welcome to everyone. Some time ago, I learned that in Singapore, sometimes it becomes a little bit awkward to wish people a warm welcome and all that because it's so hot anyway. All right, so there's a corny side of things. And writers, I think, are sometimes a little bit corny and sometimes a little bit profound. But between the sort of mischievousness of being a little bit corny and the wisdom of being very, very profound is a whole stretch. And I think most of us writers sort of are in there somewhere. And we may have our little bits of the two polarities, but by and large, we are hanging in around that. So for those of you who obviously are into very niche kind of writing, I'm sure that among the four writers we have, there'll be something for each and every one of you. The events are on every day, from today right to the closing panel on Friday. I do, at this point, want to introduce my sort of co-partner in this crime or this sitting or this very delectable process. And first of all, I'm going to introduce Prof. Robin Handal from Yale-NUS, right? Can you just give a round of applause? Robin was one of the featured writers a few years ago, and he decided that Singapore was not a bad place to be, right? And so he's back here, and they're very, very happy and privileged. And they're very happy, especially, that this first partnership with any other university has begun, and this is the Yale-NUS. We think it's good. We want to keep it going, and we hope that those of you who are from Yale-NUS and related and probably might be trying to develop relationships that will foster this partnership further and strengthen it as we go along. I think, like the sticks, you know, they all are brought up on this thing that, you know, the man has so many sons, and each of the sons had a stick, and the stick does broke. But when they tie the stick together, it became tougher. So literature can be under siege. We know this in Singapore, where the authorities are very keen to know and to recognize what's going on. And sometimes when writers are recognized in Singapore, they are recognized for two reasons. One, for being very wonderful, and two, for being a little bit naughty. The second kind of recognition actually does have all kinds of consequences, which I won't go into here, because we are speaking on a positive note. But I do want to say, and this will hopefully sort of bring us slowly into our keynote coming on, I do want to say that in a world that is getting more and more excitingly difficult, the future can do with a lot more writers expressing their views at, you know, different kinds of levels. So we are very, very keen to develop a writing culture, a literary culture, a reading culture, because I think the reading of literature is also under a kind of threat, and I'm not sure how the young are going to respond or whether new kind of writing is emerging, but these are exciting times. And we're living in exciting times. It's very, very interesting, because it always entails that people like the next person I'm going to call upon to speak have a very exciting job to do. Now, Mr. Nicholas Snyder from the US Embassy has not been able to come because of a domestic emergency, but he's wonderful, sort of number two, as it were, the deputy public affairs officer at the U.S. Embassy, is here with us. And I want to call him up and also thank him and the U.S. Embassy for being our very, very ardent supporters right from day one. And I hope this partnership with the U.S. Embassy will continue. May I now call upon Mr. William Gilbert to say a few words.